Hi, we're here at Precision Dance Center. I've been working here for the last few years, and I've been dancing with Darlene since I was 3 years old. So from teaching 14 classes a week to choreographing, ordering and checking in costumes, doing any extra work that needs to be needed, this is where I spend most of my time at. I'm here more than I am at home. So let's go inside and open up
the dirty window. So this is our studio office, and this is about my 8th or 9th time trying to make this video. It either won't load onto my computer and it won't have sound, but it'll be done. So this is my friend Jennifer videotaping. Say hi, friend.
Hi.
Okay. What is unique about me? I'm very proud of the fact that during high school, even though we had our cliques or our groups, I never categorized myself as anyone. I was a cheerleader, but I also got good grades. And as long as I liked you and you respected me and I respected you and you were a good person, I was your friend. I didn't care if you were a jock or a nerd or a skater kid, punk rock kid, whatever you want to call it. I didn't care. And I think if more people had this same thought, you would have more friends. And the more friends you have, the more fun you have. So I'm very proud of that, and I think that makes me very unique. So the best trip I ever took was in the summer of 05, between my sophomore and junior year. I went to Australia with People to People for 3 weeks. It was an amazing trip. The people were easy to get along with. There was about 30 other students, 4 chaperones, an Australian guide, and even our bus driver. You know you're a family when your bus driver is included in everything that you do. We got to meet Aboriginals. They taught us how to throw boomerangs and throw with spear. We got to snorkel at the Great Barrier Reef, hold a koala, take a tour of the Opera House, and climb to the top of the Sydney Bridge. Oh, and we got to hand feed dolphins. Awesome. I've always wanted to do that, and it was really cool because they were wild dolphins that come onto shore at night to be fed. So if you've ever thought about going to Australia but hesitated, or you've never thought about it, go. It's worth it. If I could do it again, I'd do it in a heartbeat. And that was the best trip I've ever taken. The thing that excites me the most is being in front of a crowd. Whether it's dancing or giving a speech, it gives me an adrenaline rush, and it's always fun and it's always a neat feeling and it never goes away, and I think that's always a lot of fun. And on top of that, watching my students on recital night, seeing how much they've improved from the beginning of the year, knowing that they're making lifetime memories with friends they'll have forever, and knowing that that choreography is mine. I did that, and that's my choreography, and it's something that excites me, it makes me happy, and it's something that I know I'll always love and I'll always be doing for the rest of my life. That's what excites me. If I could pick one person to go on the road with, I would choose Mother Teresa. And I choose her because although she had few possessions and she didn't come from great wealth, she still gave it all up because she realized that there were people less fortunate than her. And she gave this all up to go out there and help them and help improve their lives, because these are people without food, without home, some without family. So if I could go on the road with her for a few days or months, however long I had, and just learn to be a little bit like her and have her teach me to be less selfish, it would make me a better person and help make this a better place. And that's who I choose to go on the road with. And my boss Darlene and Katie Ann, and this is what we look like after dancing very hard all day. Bye!